Welcome to the product tutorials on creating reports in Replicon. I'm now logged in into the Replicon instance. In order to create reports, you should have access to the Reports tab available at the top. In order to get the access to the same, it is necessary that you are assigned a basic user permission set with access to reports enabled. To create new reports, click on Reports and then click on New Reports button available at the top. Choose a category that you would like the report to be created in. This will populate the report types automatically. Click on the drop-down and choose a report type. You would see some fields on the left-hand side populated automatically. Each report type has some set of fields that will be populated. However, you can delete them by clicking on the delete icon available right in front of the field name. In order to add new fields to the table, click on the search icon and search for the fields that you are looking for. Then click on the checkbox available next to the field, and the field will be showing up in the left-hand side table. You can place the field wherever you would like to. Just click on the three horizontal lines available here and move the field up or down based on the placing that you would like. Choose as many fields as you would like to and move them wherever you would like them to be placed. Coming over, you can do the grouping of the rows or the column. By grouping, we mean that the report is grouped by a certain entity available in the report. In order to group the rows, click on the drop-down and it would show the possible fields that can be used for grouping the rows. Choose the field that you would like to. In a similar way, you can group the columns. Click on the drop-down and it will show you the column fields that can be used for grouping. Choose the one that you would like to and then click on the create. The report will be created then. Now it's time to choose the filters in the report. Click on the edit icon available in front of filters and check the box against the filter that you would like to enable, or click twice to disable a particular filter. Once you're done with the selection, click on Done Editing. Choose from the filters and then click on Run Report to run this report. In order to save the report, click on the Save button available at the top right corner. This would show up a pop-up to ask you to add a name and a description if you would like to for the report. Once you're done with that, click on Save Report. You would see the name and the description coming up immediately. This is how you can create a new report in Replicon. Thank you for watching the video. Did you know that now you can get in touch with Replicon through Replicon Community? In order to access Replicon Community, on the home page, click on Customer Zone and then click on Community. You can now sign in or register and start posting your questions, queries, ideas, and one of our product management team members or the employees will get back to you immediately.